That was amazing. So everybody, another big hand for Connie Podesta. That was fantastic. Although I'm a little upset because I'm now very much in the doghouse with my wife because she's backstage, she's helping translate some of the Hungarian issues. And when Connie and Byron came up on stage, they did that little bit about when the guy comes home from work and he's had a bad day. Out of instinct, I just looked at my wife and went, Jacques! And the look I got back tells me that I'm going to be looking for that taupe couch tonight, maybe. So guys, as a little breakup from the routine here, I mentioned in my remarks previously about some of those athletes that we have that are lining up for us in Europe. And so I thought I'd show you a brief clip of some of the videos that we put together. We've done little 2-minute promotional videos with each of our athletes, and we had our guys cut some of those down into one awesome little 3-minute clip of these guys, and I'd like to show that now. So guys, let's roll it. And so she's going to come out. Maria, if I can have you come out. Now, Maria's going to show you the four poses, the body fitness poses that won her that last Balkan championship just earlier this summer. So we're going to give her the floor to show you guys what did it. we just have a few minutes here, but I do want to bring out our next guy, who's just a phenomenal kickboxer. Really, in his weight class, considered one of the best in the world. He's up and coming. He's already fought in Madison Square Garden, kicked the crap out of a guy just a few months ago out there. And he's getting ready for his first hometown, fully televised match in Novi Sad, Serbia, where Rain's going to have a pretty big presence. The guy's fantastic. Seven-time world champion in his weight class from 19 to age 26. And so he's really up and coming. I want to bring him out now. Nenad Pogonis from Serbia.
Aaron has a pretty good words about me. I'm 27 years old, coming from Serbia. Seven-time world champion, three-time European champion, but I don't like when the people call me, you know, this guy, he's a kickboxer. Because kickboxing is a little bit a rough sport, it's a gladiator, and I'm an emotional guy. I play guitar, I have my own band. I got the first category in the chess also. So it's a little bit rough, but what can I do? So Aaron told you that last year I have a fight in Madison Square Garden, and that is I think dream of every fighter, you know, because it's a big thing to fight in the hall where fight people names like Muhammad Ali, Mike Tyson, Holyfield, Rocky Marciano, you know. So it's a thing when the dreams come true. I have 105 fights. I don't look like, only my nose is broken. But I think I'm good looking, still face, because I have a friend who's a little bit destroying. I got many awards from Serbia, very big national awards. In Serbia, we got a very good fighters, but for the things for the time when kickboxing started, I'm the most successful fighter in the Serbia. Yeah, thank you. Also, I'm the only guy in the world who win the four amateur world championship and three amateur European championship in three different weight class, but all heavyweight class. So light heavyweight, middle heavyweight, and heavyweight. And I have a three professional world title, 88 kilos, 94 kilos, and 98 kilos. So it's about six heavyweight category. So I got the only regarding the soul, when we met? We met before?
About a year and
year and a half, yes. Regarding the soul, Aaron and Byron came in the right moment in my life, because 2007 I had an accident that I was put down 10 kilos. I was put down 10 kilos for the 81 kilos category in the world championship. And my immune system was down. And in Serbia we have a plant that's called Ambrosia, and it's allergic. And I got allergic, and from 2007, I got 10 years, I got allergic in August to September. It's terrible symptoms. You can breathe, you can watch your eyes that are tearing, you know, it's terrible. And first time when I met Aaron and Byron, they told me, we have a good things, you should try, we want to sponsor you. I said, okay, but I was a little bit suspicious because I have everyone coming to me, you try this, try this, try this, try this. So I was a little bit suspicious. And I didn't use it, I didn't use it maybe for August, whole month. And after I opened it and started to use it, three boxes in the day. And symptoms was very bad. And after that, maybe 3 or 4 days using soap, I was drinking coffee with my friend, and I didn't notice, and my friend told me, you don't have a symptoms of allergic anymore. And then I realized that all my symptoms are gone. And then I called Aaron. I said, listen guys, I want to promote you, I want to be with you. If you want to be with me all my career, we could done a good job. So that's my experience with the soul. I recommend that everyone will have a issue or problem, because it's a great thing and a great people. I'm very glad that I'm all with all you tonight. It's an honor for me. And they say, they ask me there, are you afraid because you going to talk with so many people? I said, I don't scare because I know that nobody gonna fight me.
I'll take you on some telephone bug fight.
I told Aaron when he come back to Novi Sad, he will train with my trainer.
And maybe then
we have to spar.
Yeah. Thanks, man. What we're gonna do, just to kind of get everybody's blood pumping, I want everybody to stand up. Come on, everybody, up out of your seats. I need one volunteer. I've got a ringer.
Who is the most braver here?
Who wants to come up and help us out with something?
I have one exercise that...
All right, come on up.
I have one exercise that show me the famous trainer. I have one exercise that show me the famous trainer, Fritz Dunek. He's a trainer of Brother Klitschko. You know who is Brother Klitschko, I know. And he's my trainer now because I start with boxing. Next year I will do boxing in Germany. Because I already win in kickboxing and everything, I don't have what to do next. So he showed me the one simple exercise, and I was asking myself and asking to him, why did I do that? And he told me, because 90% of professional boxer cannot do that. It's an exercise for the coordination. So I will not tell you what to do, I will just show you, and you just try to repeat, okay? Look this. You go like this. You will, sorry. I move like this. This. You see, I don't have a coordination also. This. 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 Right hand, right leg, left arm. No. This. Right. And left. You see? You go right. Like this. Yeah. And try to do that a couple of times.
Anyone else? Let's try everybody to do it.
So it's
everybody, on the count of three.
You there, come. Okay, first you, come. It's very easy exercise, but... Come here. It's a very easy exercise, but it's showing that we have a coordination for the fighting sport. And 90% of professional boxers cannot do that. So one more guy, okay. Come here. You see? What? This. Right leg, left arm. No. Yeah, come on. No, with the arms. Like this. This. Aaron, how do you say the diagonal?
The cross leg?
Cross leg, cross arm. This. Here. Hop.
Good job.
But use your hand. It's same length and same ground.
It's good, we got the blood pumping.
No. It's good.
Thanks guys, thanks.
Thank you.
Alright, thanks all you guys for participating. Thanks to Nenad for being the dude that he is. And Go Ray Nation. Thanks everybody.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.